So I wanted to show you how I make my YouTube Periscope photography background, and I figured this would be the best way. Now you have two options. There are probably more, but these are the two options I would use. And so I'm going to show you the supplies you need. And I'm also going to show you how I do both options. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. I went on YouTube to find this, and there weren't a whole lot of videos. So I wanted to share what I do to make my YouTube. So as far as the backdrops go, I have two options for you. You can have a mobile backdrop, and you'll need some supplies from your local retail store. And you can also do one that you actually have on the wall. I'm going to do the mobile one first because I'm going to actually take it apart and use the same fabric to use for the wall. And then I'm going to make it more pretty with the one on the wall. So as far as the supplies go, for the glitzy, glamour one, I am going to be using these dream tassels. I got these from Target, and they were on clearance. I want to say they were $2 a pack, but the regular price ones are $5.99 or $4.99 or $4. And this is what they look like, and they're in the party section. You're also going to need a piece of fabric that you like. I picked this one, or my mom picked this one for me, and she just got this from like a fabric store. You can go to Michael or Hobby Lobby if you don't have like a fabric store just for fabric in your area, but you do have a Hobby Lobby or Michael's, and I think even Walmart sells fabric. For the wall one, you're also going to need a hammer and thumbtacks, or yeah, push pins. And these were just from like Dollar Tree. For the mobile one, you're going to need the clamps, and I got these in the painting section at Walmart, and they were 99 cents a piece. And you're also going to need a step stool. If you're short like me, I'm only 5'2", so anything above that I need to get to. And I use a portable chair in mine, one of those folding chairs, whenever I like to sit down to do my videos. So that's pretty much up to you. For the wall one, I am going to make sure to put it above my head door if I'm standing, and also make sure that the streamers are above, you know, where I could sit or where I could stand. So let's get into making the mobile one. Usually, this is a clothing hanger wrap, which I'll tell you guys all about. But this one is for my mobile backdrop. My mobile backdrop I usually use so that I can film like in my living room with my family. And also if I just wanna, you know, chase the lighting around my house. I have good lighting, but sometimes I just wanna be able to be in a different room besides my filming room, but I still want a backdrop. So I do use a clothing wrap that you can get from Walmart. Fabric, and you're going to need your clothing wrap. What you're going to do is you are going to line up the corners on all sides. So pretty much fold it in half. And you're going to fold it in half the wrong way, so that you have all the length. How long your clothing rack is, and then get something that can actually have a little bit of hanging space if you need additional. So once you fold it in half, make sure you fold all of them in half, and that's just an easier guide. Now you're gonna open it up and extend it across your clothing rack. I hope y'all can see it. better for like close up, where you're not going to see that extra space hanging over. The wall one is more for like if you're doing a fashion haul or a fashion try on, you may need a little bit more length, but the wall one is better for that because you actually don't see the mechanics. Alright, and then you just do the same thing to the other side. And then this is what you have. And then you can just sit and record your video. I usually do like a closer in when I'm using this. But this is also great like if you have a like a Skype interview or like Periscope or something like that, where they're really just seeing like this one, you know, like it's more on your face. So this will be in the background and then it'll be on your face. So I hope that one was helpful. Like I said, I use this to film like in different parts of my house. Because my rack actually has wheels on it, I can like wheel it into the living room, I can wheel it into the dining room, wherever I need to go to film. You know, when you get that inspiration, you just gotta go for it. So next we're gonna get into the wall one. So let's do that. I have taken all of my products out the packaging, like the streamers, and my fabric is already ready to go. Another tip is you can put your fabric in the dryer if it's heat safe and with a wet washcloth or wet piece of cloth. Don't wet this cloth and then put it on tumble dry or a good heat setting and actually get the wrinkles out. I see a lot of videos and their backdrop is nice, but it has like wrinkles and things like that in it. So that is a whole nother option to actually take out the wrinkles without having to press it. That's just, you know, a little tip. So now that we have finished doing our mobile one, we want to do the one for the wall. So you just want to grab one of your thumbtacks. You may need two, but I'm going to grab one for now. And I'm going to grab my fabric as well. And I'm just going to grab my hammer. So you're going to have, I'm going to take two thumbtacks. So you just want to hang it. But I wanted to get this video out for you guys. I have a lot of filming to do today. And so I wanted to start with making this particular video because I need this backdrop for the rest of my videos. So I will see you in another one. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't talk about me. Don't be sharing this all over YouTube like beauty guru. Bye. As you can see, this is how I made my background. I hope this video was very helpful for you. You don't need a lot of items. I am thinking about actually making backdrops for you guys with more logos and more things like that. So guys, let me know what you think. But I hope this is helpful for you. This is easy and you can do this with a really small budget. I think everything might have been like $50, and that was including the clothing rack. So I hope this was helpful for you. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Share it with your friends who want to be YouTube bloggers and bloggers. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I will see you in the next one.